When I started work, I went out service for 3 years at Normanton. I was 10 years away, and I woke the next day. Well, it ain't love, I don't tell you lies. I started work at 10 years of age, half a crown a week in my grub and lodgings. I was there 3 years. I left there and I went to Hathern Brickyard. I was there perhaps 12 months. I got 6 bob a week. 6 in the morning till 6 at night, no, half past 6 in the morning, half an hour breakfast, an hour dinner, and knocked off at 5:30. 6 bob a week, and I worked till 2 o'clock a Saturday. I left there, and then I went to the Socks Mill for 10 bob a week. One of his mates got the sack, and I went in his place for 10 bob a week of days and a week of nights. I was there 6 years till I got Ed Grand at the last 2 years I was there. One of Ed Grand's lot responsible for the grinding. Mm-hmm. Well, then I left there and went back to the brickyard, and I was there with a bit of time before I left, and went back. I was here 44 years, and I never again me thanked me, only got a week money in hand. I did. Me and my son both come off together. But they put, let the kill go out, take on account of the zeps and that.
Oh, yes.
You say there's all more, you're very right, what you round the caps where the heat's coming up, but what it finds the bits of second down, it's shown, you say, and they know it purpose for the zeps and that. I won't be when the bloody zeps come over. And the first German war, boy, I got when they got down to where is it? Stanton, which they had the bums off in. They do some damage there. Well, I went from, when we went off at the kill go out, I went from there to Fuller's. I was there 15 years. Listen what I'm telling you. I was firing the boiler there and helping the factory unload and pack the yarn and that, all like of that, and looking after 2 gardens for them. I dug it up from turf and chopped them all the stick and that, you know, for the fires, the bosses. Dry it on the boil and then chopped it up for them. And when I left, now listen, I went to my Stanley one Monday morning. I said, I won't see Mr Stanley, he's a boss. I said, all right, so I'm back in a minute. He said, go on in the office, I'm back in a minute. Well, I said, you know what I've come for, don't you? I said, I've read a rumour. I said, I want to finish where you next Friday night. All being well, I said, I said, you don't want to talk like that. I said, yeah, another 10 years yet. Well, I'm going 82 now.
Really?
Oh, I'm.
You don't look it.
Doesn't matter, bugger, I'm not send on it. Yes, I'm going 82. And I said, bugger my stand, I'm not going to walk till I drop dead. Oh, well, I said, never mind, I says, but when he was coming through the factory, he brought his wife, this young woman from Loughborough. I was in the yarn room, and I was talking to Mr. Reeve, and he says, I haven't forgot you. Well, I've got to go in, I'd finish then, mind you. I said, he hadn't forgot me. So I went to the factory. I had to go in and get the money, because I got to load a load of the scrap, all scrap stuff up, you know, to go to the, be all done again, weaved out again. Went to Relays Mills, Manchester Road somewhere, and I went back again and again with 30 bob, and that was finished. But anyhow, his son lives up Shepherd Road, opposite my gardens, and he come to me and says, Harris, I thought we were going to have a bit of a deal when you left us. I says, how did you? I says, my God, I said, it fell through. So, I said, near mine, I says, you man, come and have a pair of 2 socks when you want. And I didn't. I went again with 4 pairs of these this year. Last year I got 6 pairs. Mm. That's all I've ever had in my life. Mm. And I've never had a copper left in my life, and neither sides. Mm. Never in my life, not a copper. And I've only had the sack but once in my life, and I deserved it. But I doesn't tell you what it was over.
Each day I live, I should be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every gain to taste the sweet. I face the pain. I rise and fall, yet through it all, this much remains. No.